Hey guys, what's going on? This is David, and it is not even do a timer this week, but I will say this video is brought to you by Panera Bread. Actually, it's really not, but if you're corporate office of Panera and you want to sponsor this, listen, let me know. I would love to have Panera sponsor this moving forward, or any other company, as a matter of fact. With that said, let's get started. Barna Research, they did this State of the Church. They do it every year. In 2020, it's been obviously different for everyone, and they talked about online church. And they were mentioning that one-third of regular active church-going attendees no longer watch a church service online. One half of active church-going millennials are no longer watching church online either. And these are regular attendees prior to COVID-19. I'm not surprised, to be honest with you, because you know, online church isn't the same. But here's the thing, I don't think it was ever meant to be like this. I don't think God ever wanted what we look at as church, go watch, receive, look at, learn. That's part of it. But I think we've taken a consumerism, applied it into our church experience, into our spirituality, into our walk with God. I don't think it was ever meant to be that way. Now let's fast forward to Matthew 25. This is one of the verses or portion of scripture I've been meditating on during the pandemic, just sitting on this. And if you look at the story of the virgins, these virgins were waiting for the bridegroom to come. They weren't knowing exactly when, but when he showed up, it was kind of unexpected. Some of them had enough oil for the journey. Other ones were, their oil was about to run out. And the ones who were lacking oil looked at the ones who had enough, and they said, hey, give me some of your oil. And the wise virgins, the Bible calls them, says, hey, no, we don't have enough. You need to go and buy from the one who has it. Fast forward to Revelation chapter 3, verse 18. Jesus is admonishing the church in Laodicea, and he says, buy for me oil, anointment, salve, that you can apply to your eyes. Buy it from me. And he admonishes the church to buy anointment, oil. Now, it's a different Greek word for oil, but here's the thing. I think we've taken our church experience, and what we do is we, in the past, prior to COVID, we would go to church, receive from the pastor, receive from the worship team, receive enough for the week, and then we go. Instead of receiving from the Lord, knowing what he has in his heart for our week, knowing what he has ahead of us, like hearing from him directly. And it was never meant to be this consumer Christianity. It was never meant to be this way. And I think if we continued, we'd be like the virgins who had not enough oil for the journey, not enough oil. And we'd say, give us, pastor, give us this oil. And he's like, no, listen, you got to go to someone else. You got to buy for yourself. But Jesus is admonishing us during this time, buy from me, receive from me, because that's how it was always meant to be. He's torn the veil. He's taken away all the intermediaries. You don't have to just go to the building and receive from the Lord. The building, the church, the pastors, they were all great things, but it was never meant to be the replacement for Jesus himself. Guys, I want to encourage you in this time. When you know, I know you can't, some of you may not be able to meet up with your regular church family, or you may be in this unique situation. Spend time with Jesus. Receive from him. He wants to heal. He wants to anoint you. He wants to fill you afresh. But that only comes from him, not from someone else. It was never meant to be that way. It was always meant to come from the source. Guys, this is a two-minute video. It might have been longer than 2 minutes. But I hope it blessed you. I hope it encouraged you. If it did, do me a favor. Just share that in the comment below. Let me know. Also, moving forward, I didn't do a video last week. My apologies. But we're kind of working, thinking ahead to do a better production. As you can see, this is probably not the best production right now, but doing these videos with a higher quality, I should say, moving forward. So we're working on that. You may not get a video next week. It may be a little bit to lose regular videos again. I'm going to try to do them as I can, sporadically even. But just want to let you know, just want to be on the same page with you guys as well. Also, we're looking at possibly doing a Hearing the Voice of God session or the equipping session, as we've done in person the past, during last year and the year before, and the year before that, and the year before that. But we've always done those in person. We've never done it online. So we're looking at the possibility of doing it online. Listen, if that's something that encourages you, like you want to learn how to hear God's voice, you want to learn how to prophesy, you want to learn how to just spend time with the Lord and hear his voice, and learn how to give a word of knowledge or how to prophesy, let me know in the comment below. Let me know if that's something you'd be interested in, because I'm talking with some of my friends who I've done these events with in the past, and we're trying to see if we can do this online. We'd love to gauge your interest in that as well. Guys, this is a 2-minute video. I hope it bless you. Until next time, love you all. Talk to you later.